Hi there, my name is Gunjan. Welcome to my channel. So today I am going to share a recipe of keto yeast bread. It's going to be low carb bread and it's vegetarian and vegan bread because I'm not going to use any dairy product and I'm not going to use any eggs in this. I have come up with this recipe after lots and lots of trials and error because I know there are so many keto breads are available out in the market, but the biggest challenge with these breads are they taste too eggy, and it's not their fault because the keto flours are really heavy. So to give our keto bread a substantial rise, we have to use this many eggs. But this recipe is going to be a game changer. It's an amazing keto bread recipe which will need no eggs in it. And please, it's a request, do watch this video carefully because I'm going to talk about all the ingredients I'm going to use in this recipe so that it will clear all of your doubts, and I'm going to show all the nutritional label of those products which I'm going to use so that you know that these are keto approved products. So without any further delay, let's go ahead and check out this amazing keto yeast bread recipe. And before that, if you are new to my channel, a very warm welcome. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and let's go to the recipe.
So as the title suggested, this is going to be keto yeast bread, and for that we have to activate the yeast. And in order to do that, here I have taken my glass jar, and to this I have added 7 gram of active dry yeast. And to activate this, I am going to use inulin. Now this is insoluble prebiotic fiber. This is really low in carb and it has got some sweet properties which is used to activate the yeast. And yes, you cannot use erythritol or any other keto approved sweetener to activate the yeast. And to this I am adding 1 cup of lukewarm water. This is not hot water, it is lukewarm water. This should be warm to touch and give everything all a good mix. The temperature of the water is really important in order to activate the yeast. Too much of warm water will kill the yeast, and very cold water will not activate the yeast. So be careful about that. Now I have covered it up and allow this to proof for 20 to 30 minutes in the warmest area of your house. And while our yeast is proofing, we'll start mixing our flours. And for that, here simply I have taken my mixing bowl, and to this I'm going to add oat fiber. Now I really want to clarify something here. This is oat fiber, it is not oat flour. It has got zero net carb, as you can see here, and it has got zero calorie. This is an amazing ingredient and it gives a really good texture to our keto low carb yeast bread. And now next, the ingredient I'm going to use here, it is gluten flour, and this ingredient is must. There is no replacement for this ingredient in our keto low carb yeast bread, and this particular ingredient is responsible for the texture of our keto yeast bread. This is gluten which is separated from the wheat, and this is highly nutritious and really low in carb. And this really gives an amazing texture to our keto low carb yeast bread. And once I have added gluten flour, next I am adding 1.5 cup of almond flour. And once that is done, give everything all a good mix and remove all the lumps if there is any. And once that is done, set this aside. Let's go ahead and check on our yeast after 15 to 20 minutes. And look at this, our yeast has proofed nicely. This is how your yeast mixture should look like. It has doubled in size. If your yeast mixture does not look something like this, that means your yeast did not get activated and you have to start making your yeast starter again. And here now I am adding my yeast mixture to my flour mixture, followed by 3 tablespoons of olive oil. If you want to use avocado oil or melted butter or ghee, you can definitely sub this for olive oil and give everything all a good mix. And now it's time to knead it. So with my hand, I'm mixing everything all up. For the mixing of the dry and wet ingredients, you can use your food processor if you want to. I don't want to use too many utensils, that's why I'm using my hand for this procedure, but you can definitely use your food processor. And once all the flour has come together, I will transfer this to my clean kitchen top, and I'm going to knead this with the help of my hand. Now here you have to knead your dough for 5 to 7 minutes. This is really important step. If you do not knead your dough for 5 to 7 minutes, your dough will not rise substantially. I know this is some labor intensive job, but think of it as some arm workout and knead your dough for 5 to 7 minutes. Once your dough is soft and supple in texture and no longer sticky, give this a rectangular shape. And now I am going to place this in my loaf tin. The exact size of my loaf tin is in the description below. And cover it and allow this to proof for 1 hour in the warmest area of your house. I am keeping this in my oven. And after 1 hour, just look at this. It has rose nicely. After 1 hour, your dough should be double in the size, like this. Can you see this? And now it's time to bake this. Now I'm going to bake this at 180 degrees Celsius for about 45 minutes. And once it is baked, immediately transfer this to your cooling rack. And wow, the aroma of freshly baked yeast bread is so good. And the amazing part about this bread is it's keto and low carb. And once it has cooled down completely, let me slice a piece and show you the texture of it. And can you see that? It looks so much like a store-bought bread. And let me show you the texture. It has nice, soft and chewy texture, and I'm sure you're going to love this recipe. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.